Good morning. Hey, there we go. That's good for 11:35 on a Tuesday. Thank you so much for coming. Coming up on the show, we take a look at some of the new announcements around the built-in security and operations management in Azure that helps with your productivity through native intelligence, including machine learning-based recommendations and threat information sourced from the Microsoft Intelligent Security Graph, centralized update management to keep your VMs patched and up to date, granular policies to enhance control within your infrastructure, and much more. Now, I'm joined by Jeremy Winter, whose teams run the management services for Azure. So give him a warm round of applause.
Hey, thanks for having me. It's good to see you again.
Yeah, you too. Thanks for joining us. Yeah. So tell us a little bit about what built-in security and operations management is all about, and help us understand some of the announcements.
Yeah, absolutely. So when we think about management and we think about platform, we see them as the same. Management platform, platform management. So what we really wanted to do here is just bring management and security just native into Azure. So as you're sitting here thinking about, as I move my workloads there, it's just there. It's already in. You don't have to go look for a separate set of tools. And it really gives that enterprise that level of confidence that we've got these core capabilities there.
Nice.
And so as you can see on the screen as we think through it, it's just really whether you have governance or security, which is what we're going to talk a bit today about, we also have a whole bunch of areas around configuration, monitoring, and how to protect your data from backups and disaster recovery. So we're just quite a bit of stuff now just built into Azure.
And there's some additional announcements we made at the conference.
Yeah. So just at the conference, we've been announcing a handful of things. These are just a few of the key ones where we're thinking, as we look at announcing threat investigation, what we're doing with adaptive whitelisting so we can see what's going on inside the apps to help you there. This really new advanced log analytics, it's a next generation of what we've already had and a much more advanced way for deep queries. And then we brought in update management and then this policy.
I'm going to look at some of those. So let's dive into some of these announcements in a little bit more depth. And naturally, security is on everybody's mind. It's an incredibly important topic. And it's good to know that security and management is just built in. But what does that really mean for people?
So built in. We really just wanted to make this pretty simple. And so inside, this is the Azure Portal. And the Azure Portal, we just look at it as management. And so you've got all the dashboards and things that I can pin in to just view and have that extensibility. But he's talking about, like, how do we make it easy? Just where do we find these things built in? So if I just choose the VMs, I'm just selecting the different VMs that are installed in there. And if I just do a quick just search, we're just going to look for those Contoso VMs. You can see here's all these VMs that are inside Linux and Windows. Now, if I come in and just look, let's pick a Windows machine. Here's Contoso Web 2. I'm able to now quickly, right inside the VM itself, we've added operations and monitoring. So here's your section. Operations are just built in. You can go do it directly within the VM. They're all centered right there, front and center for you to go. So, you know, you look at updates, right? You talk about security.
Yep.
Boy, this is one where we really just try to make sure that all the core elements are up to date so that we don't get those vulnerabilities inside.
Incredibly important.
Yeah. So this is where we've just built update management. It's included in your Azure subscription. You can go ahead and use it. It's at no cost. You're able to come in and start to look at all those missing updates on that VM. Again, for Linux or Windows.
Okay, cool.
And so I can quickly just go in and look at all the different updates that are needed, and I can schedule those updates. But a lot of times, we want to look at updates not just on one machine, but them all. And so we have the ability to look at the entire real estate of that environment for your updates. I can see all the compliant and non-compliant machines that are inside, whether they're Windows or Linux. And I can go schedule. So let's just do a real quick schedule, since we may want to do something a bit reactive and get, like, JDub quick patch. I can classify. So I can go choose, like, look, I just want this critical update. And I may want to go exclude updates or do the right timing, set up the schedule for this reoccurring, and even a maintenance window.
The maintenance window is key because people maintain those to ensure they can patch
within those windows. So we heard loud and clear that as we think about those core capabilities, give me the schedule as well as that.
And to reiterate, this update service is free. It's included. There's no extra service.
It also does it for your non-Azure resources. So you'll see right inside, I can do my non-Azure. So you can use the same technology to reach back to your on-site. We want to make sure you're using Azure. As you start to think about this hybrid, and I have environments in both areas, let's use our patch and our other elements to go reach on-site or even environments that aren't on our cloud like AWS or Google.
Cool.
And so this really just gives you that level of I'd say, protection and that view to really make sure you're managing those updates across the environment.
Now, back in the list of operations you could perform there, I saw something that's traditionally very hard to keep up with for IT, and that's change tracking.
Yeah.
So tell us a bit about that.
Yeah, so good. So change tracking, this is one of the elements that we also added. When we think about change, sometimes change is just happening inside the environment. And so here's a Linux machine that I'm looking at what's changed across the environment. And so we have the ability now to be able to see what's going on inside the guest. You're able to go look at what's happening inside, whether on a Linux, the events, the files, the daemons, the software. In your Windows, we're thinking about our registry and Windows services. It's the same piece inside. And I can show you that. But here's you just looking across the overall change. It's also super valuable because as we start to think about change in the environment, these are elements that you may want to keep from a compliance point of view. Mm-hmm. So the change that's occurring inside the guest goes to our overall Azure activity log, where all the systems, all the elements are writing the changes and the activities that are going on. And so now you're also able to get what's going on inside the guest.
Right, cool.
And so that's a pretty critical piece.
And we mentioned briefly protection and backups listed there as well.
Yeah, for sure. So when we think about backup, this is one of those core elements that if I just go to backup, we'll just dive in there.
Why not?
Take a look, right?
Yeah.
So this is a machine I have backup set on. So since we're talking security, we had kind of some ransomware that kind of spun up for us back, a lot of us, in June with WannaCry. Mm-hmm. And we saw that quite a few customers started to go look at protecting those workloads. And so with backup, you can, whether it's on-site workloads or the workloads on Azure, you can start to back those up. So then is in a circumstance where you're locked out of those machines, you have that data protected and you have those instances protected back in the cloud. And we have multi-factor auth to be able to ensure that if someone is working their way back to those backup elements, that you're able to have the authentications and the validation to make sure that no one's tampering with those.
So preventing the ransomware from accessing the backups, essentially.
Yeah, so I could basically just go into restore and restore at a checkpoint that we have, and off we go.
Excellent. So many of these areas are reactive, but how can we start to use some of the built-in management and security in more of a proactive way?
Yeah, so that brings us to this policy piece. We just announced it. It's a limited preview. You can come out onto the Azure.com and look for policy and sign up for it there.
Right.
But I'll just show you where that is. So this is policy. Now policy, this has given us a whole new opportunity to start to think about, I as a custodian of the cloud, how do I still ensure those safeguards of my environment? How do I ensure those configurations and the elements that I want to have happen are happening, but I still can give the velocity to the developers or my other business teams? I want them to use the cloud and our services, but I also don't want to get in the way. And so this is this notion of policy and initiatives. Policies we're all pretty familiar with. It's what are the settings that I want to do to monitor and make sure. But initiatives allows us, it's a new element that allows us to group many, many policies into one thing.
Nice.
So an example, if I want to think about, like, how do I secure my express route? How do I think about all the policies that I want to go with that? So I'll give you a show. So I just chose the Security Express Route Initiative, and you can see all the policies that are listed. Most of them are already compliant, but I have one that's focused on out of compliant. This is where I don't want any machines configured to be outbound to the public IP address. I want to protect my internal networks. And so if I go look, I can select that, and it'll take me right to those specific resources that are not compliant. Now, this could be an initiative I've already had in place, but then something came and I noticed people weren't configuring the public IPs. So I can just add that to the initiative and then be able to track that as one point.
Right.
Now, this one we have set as an audit. If you just look right here in kind of the summary, we have audit. And this allows our customers and us, as we started to work with our big customers and MSIT, or Microsoft IT, that we wanted to be able to audit first, just to kind of get a state of where we're at, and then start to go enforce.
Right.
And for everyone that's thinking about, well, how did they go build this? We did this right on top of Azure Resource Manager. So it's there for all your Azure resources. And if anyone's really thinking about, well, how did they do the definitions? It's really just set on top of JSON and that Azure Resource Manager. So you can see here, we've got, for us, looking at the JSON around, this is my public IP addresses. These are just ARM configurations.
Right.
And then we have it set to audit. But this allows you to really go manage all of those. And it's easy to just go create your own. If I wanted to go create my own, I could create my own definition. We have them built in. And,
right, lot of common ones built in to help people with best
for
practices
sure.
and so on. And
for sure.
So if I was a developer, speaking of JSON and ARM templates, if I'm a developer building a standard template and deploying images within Azure, this would catch if I forgot to deny public IP, for instance.
Yeah, that's right. And so at the time of when I go into create new and I just start to go choose those resources, it'll block me right there and tell me why and allow me to go look at the policy.
Okay.
Let's
change direction slightly and talk about security threats that might be happening right now.
Yeah, like
how
right
can you
now.
Help, like right now.
Yeah, yeah.
What can we do?
So this is the announcement we put around the Azure Security Center. And so built into Azure, we've added not only the Azure Security Center, but a whole bunch of new threat intelligence, as well as investigations to really help. So why don't we pop over and look at the Azure Security Center.
Sounds good.
So inside the Azure Security Center, this is our hub for all things security that's going on across Azure. But one of the announcements we did is also we made this hybrid. So now all of these core capabilities can also be reached back into the on-site or other environments. Again, we really just want to make sure that as you use this new modern technologies and modern solutions in the cloud, you can leverage them back.
Nice, cool.
And so if we just take a look at just a quick little run through of some of these, we've got, you know, we have the standard compute and the recommendations that are inside. So we'll just give you recommendations that you should just be able to leverage. I mean, who wouldn't? They're already built in.
Yep.
But these new announcements that we were talking about are really twofold.
Right.
The application controls and our overall security. So let's look at the application, the adaptive application controls. So what is this? The adaptive application is we've used machine learning, and we'll watch how the apps are running inside your environment. Now, you may use desired state config or other elements, but a lot of times the apps are already out there. And so we can profile those apps and look at what are the VMs, what are the applications and the processes, and we learn over time what the right state is going to be. And then from a security point of view, you can set that as a configuration to then later go make sure that if any deviant, any changes from this, such as a new workload or an XE drops into the environment, you can quickly be flagged on it from the security point of view.
Right.
So here we look at recommended. Now it takes some time for our systems to go learn, but I can look at the Contoso automation, and it's going to automatically, if you look at the screen, it allows me to see the virtual machines in that resource group and the processes that I typically know.
Right.
So if all of a sudden a GetHash XE runs or something, some other solution is dropped in, we can flag that from a security specific perspective.
Excellent.
So we already have capabilities inside Azure for desired state config. And allows us to think about it from a management, but we also put this other piece from that overall analytics and machine learning piece. Good.
That's cool.
Yeah.
So what about the threat investigation?
Yes. Threat
this
investigation.
This is a big one.
Yep, this is a big one. So inside, let's go look at the alerts, Matt.
Yep.
And when we look at the alerts, we can see all the different threats or actions that we think have already been flagged inside the system. And here we bundle security incident detected. And we bundle the different pieces that are inside that we see, like, we see a suspicious process executed and an RDP brute force. This is something we want to take a look at. Now, typically we give a breakdown of this, and this is where prior to Ignite, we had a core view that just told you what the description is and kind of how to learn more about it. Well, what we see, even from our own security teams at Microsoft, is we need to do the investigation. And right now, this is a as we think about this in the past, it's a collection of a variety of different data sources. But since we have this rich analytics engine that's shared across all those management components that I talked about earlier, we're able to start to really get some powerful analytics that now helps me see through that IT graph and where the actual attack vectors are coming from and how I need to respond to it.
Right.
And so this is, if we look at the overall security incidents that are inside, I can start to use this graph to drill in and say, I had this security incident, but we talked about that RDP brute force. And inside that brute force, I can now see that it impacted this Contoso web machine, and we had different actions or players that were involved with it. Now, if I went and did some exploration inside this, I could see, we could use these built in, we could start to go see other elements that are occurring with this machine. Mm-hmm. And one of the examples we could see is Abby, one of my users in my environment, clearly he's had some additional suspicious activity. She signed in from an unfamiliar location that I wouldn't expect. Let's go take a look further. And it just keeps working down the graph visually for our security experts to be able to go see quickly, yes, this was the machine, or this is how Abby came in through a brute force with Contoso Web, but then laterally moved to another machine and executed that suspicious process.
Right.
Now again, if we have the analytics, we're able to start to go flow And if you use the elements like our just-in-time control to have limit the access to what ports, or you use the application where we're starting to see the whitelisting, we'd be able to catch this, but we didn't hear.
No, okay.
So now we're going to go investigate it a little further.
Well, that leads us on nicely, because I'm curious about where all of this data is coming from that's powering all of this, this rich kind of view that we've got here.
Yep, and this is kind of at the heart of this analytics. And we have this advanced analytics element that we're in the middle, we had last year as what we'll call Gen 1. And now we're rolling out Gen 2 analytics. It's really centered. We're in the middle of the rollout right now. It's in beta. Everyone can come use it. And here's how it works inside the security side. But this is, again, consistent across all the management components that we talked about earlier. So if I go choose that machine, let's go back to Contoso Web, where it all kind of began.
Yeah.
I can do exploration. And we've already done some of the logic to point you to the areas that you should focus on, like the distinct processes that were executed, the things we should be watching for.
Mm-hmm.
But behind that is log analytics. Now, log analytics, like I said, has been inside Azure for the last year. We've seen an immense amount of usage of this, and really people starting to go customize and driving their data through this, both from a monitoring perspective as well as a security perspective. This is just a pretty rich capability for you to go drill down in, use search context pretty simply. It can even narrow down on a time frame to see what's happened. And we're groveling through millions and millions of logs to get it right there.
Right. Yeah, I was going to ask, is this just a few items of data, a few logs, or is this billions and it's a lot?
Yeah, it's
fast.
It is. So this we've had. But the piece that we now have is the advanced analytics. And what that does is it really allows us to have a much deeper and much more advanced analytics capability. You can write your own queries, you can write your own joins, you can start to have your own logic around here. You take your own apps, start to have your own custom apps, your own custom logs and telemetry writing into this. We even see customers using this for their points of sale devices as they're still Azure customers, but using this to monitor their points of sale devices. And so this gives me this rich query capability as my security personnel want to start to go drive down, or even I as an IT need to be able to see this information because security's on me too.
Awesome.
So we can just look quickly, like show me the specific non-system processes are running. I could see, do I have any computers where they're starting to wipe my logs? Because when that happens, you know, attacks will come in, I'll start to clean my trail. So this just gives us a much more advanced capability to go run through, and pretty powerful, and gives that level of advancedness, not only from the helping you see the intelligence that we have with the charts and the graphs and the ready-made intelligence, but also just walking us through, you know, getting us to the advanced analytics.
Yeah, incredibly powerful. Awesome. Well, thank you very much, Jeremy, for walking us through the new announcements around the built-in security and management on Azure. But the key question is, where can people learn more?
Yeah, so I'd go, first off, just go out to AMS Free. We already have it there. Get your hands on it and learn how to create these VMs. We have labs that are available for you to start to go. They're already pre-built. So go out to the labs and start to go learn. But again, free, get your hands on it, and go learn more.
Yeah, and test it out. Awesome. Well, thanks, Jeremy.
Hey,
that's all we've got time for. Yeah, thank you very much for your time.
Love it.
And we'll see you next time on Microsoft Mechanics.